For me, it was a matter of deep sense of internal urgency combined with a sense that I was on a treadmill that didn't change very much. So at some point, I'll start with the latter. There was a clear sense that whatever it was that I was doing in academia, I was doing pretty well. I had a, you know, a steady stream of high profile grants. I had incredible graduate students and we were producing papers, and it got to the point where it's like yet another paper, yet another grant. And that was all very well and good. But I began to feel a sense of urgency to do something meaningful that actually touched the lives of people. And actually one, it's interesting that the real transition point in sort of really driving that home was, ironically enough, that MacArthur Award that you mentioned in the introductory comments. When I got that, that was in 2004. And most people, when they get an award like that, they celebrate. And it threw me into like a deep funk. And the reason for that was because this is not the kind of other awards that I'd gotten before, like the National Academy of Engineering and such, where there is a relatively limited group of people who are even eligible to be considered for that award. And I was a plausible enough candidate. This was something that could have been given to any one of the residents of the United States. And I was like, why me? There's so many amazing people out there. What have I done to really earn it? And I went back and looked at my publication record and I said, are all these papers really enough to have caused me to be selected as one of, you know, a handful, 25 people out of, you know, at that point, 250 million people in the United States? That it doesn't seem like I'm the most obvious candidate. And I felt like I had to pay it forward. And so basically was, what can I do to make the world a better place that would retroactively earn me this award? And so that combined with the fact that when we at Stanford, based on much of the work that I'd done, even internally within Stanford on technology assisted education, suddenly we had these big, you know, courses, these MOOCs with, you know, 200,000 learners in each one. And it was like, this is a really big thing. So am I going to go back and write more papers, or am I really going to go out and try and make a difference in the world? And so I decided that I just couldn't let that opportunity go by to really make a difference.